Hey everyone, I'm Max Dalton, and in this video, I'll show you how to set up and use a sign-in with Apple account. As part of its rollout of iOS 13 in late 2019, Apple rolled out Sign-in with Apple, which lets users easily set up accounts in apps using their Apple ID. The service lets you use an alternate name and choose whether or not you want to hide your email address. Signing into apps on your iPhone or iPad using Sign-in with Apple is incredibly easy, and you can sign into these apps outside of the Apple ecosystem using your Apple ID account as well, although that process is a bit more cumbersome. In this video, I'll walk through how to set up and use a Sign-in with Apple account, and I'll show you how to sign into those apps using your Apple ID account in a web browser. First, let's look at how to set up Sign-in with Apple in an app that supports the feature. Step 1. Launch the app you want to create a Sign-in with Apple account on. Step 2. Tap Login, Sign-in, or the equivalent. In this example, using the Pocket app, I'll tap Login. The login screen appears. For apps that support Sign-in with Apple, you'll see Continue with Apple in the list of options. Step 3. Tap Continue with Apple. A Sign-in with Apple ID menu flies up from the bottom of the screen. Step 4. Tap the Name field to bring up a screen where you can change your first and last name that's used to set up your account for this app. In the Email section, if you want to share one of the real email addresses associated with your Apple ID with the application, tap to select Share My Email. The Share My Email section expands, and you can choose which email address associated with your Apple ID you want to share with this app. Alternatively, if you don't want to share a real email address with the app that will be associated with your account, you can choose Hide My Email. When you choose Hide My Email, Apple will set up a placeholder account for you that will forward all information sent to your account from this app to the primary email address associated with your Apple ID. Step 5. Tap Continue after entering all of the required information. Your sign-in with Apple account will be created in this app, and you'll be taken to the app where you can start using it. Now, the next time you open the app and are prompted to log into this app on your iPhone or iPad, you'll need to select Continue with Apple. An Apple ID menu will fly up from the bottom of the screen asking if you want to sign into this app with your Apple ID. Tap Continue. You'll need to supply the required authentication, and then you'll be logged into the app. Now let's look at how you access apps on websites with your sign-in with Apple account. Step 1. Open a web browser and navigate to the website for the service where you set up a sign-in with Apple account, and then click Login. Step 2. Click Continue with Apple in the list of login options. A screen appears prompting you to enter your Apple ID. Step 3. Enter your Apple ID and then click the right pointing arrow. Enter the password associated with your Apple ID on the next screen and tap the right pointing arrow again. A two-factor authentication screen appears, prompting you to enter the 6-digit Apple ID verification code sent to your Apple device. Step 4. Enter the verification code you received. The next screen asks if you want Sign-in with Apple to trust this browser going forward. Choosing to trust a browser means you won't be asked for a verification code the next time you use Sign-in with Apple on this web browser. The next screen will ask if you want to continue to your app with your Apple ID. Click Continue. You'll be logged into your application using your Apple ID. Let me know what your favorite new iPhone feature is in the comments below. If you liked what you saw here, click the video link on the right side of the screen to check out another video. Or click the logo on the left side of the screen to subscribe to this channel to see more great videos like this one.